Hi everyone, it's Ella, and I hope you're having a wonderful day. Welcome back to another episode? Another random video of me talking randomly and rambling at you, because that's what I like to do. This is another instance of brain barf. Yay, I'm gonna barf my brain onto you. I was listening to this podcast of bedtime stories, and one thing that it said that I found very helpful is to imagine as if there's a door on your head. There's a front door and there's a back door, and the way to keep moving forward and not get caught on a thought is to imagine the front door opening and letting everything in, and the back door opening and letting everything out, and it just keeps flowing in and out the front and back door. I have problems of getting stuck on thoughts and problems with moving on from things. I've always been like that. It's just the way that I am. It's hardwired in me. There's been several tricks that I've used in order to keep moving forward, because that's important. And just overall, I've been trying to watch more movies, you know, read more books, listen to more stories, because I think that it's very, very crucial to be surrounding ourselves with stories from all different kinds of people, especially right now, with Black Lives Matter movement becoming so prominent in our everyday lives. I've been doing a lot of reflection on ways that my thoughts are biased, and that all of our thoughts are biased, because this is the way that our society is constructed and the way that we are all raised since we're little and we're watching Disney princesses that are all white and are waiting for their Prince Charming to come and save them because we need men to save us. It's so interesting to see all of the ways that Disney princesses have messed up our brains. They kind of suck. They have not taught us good things. But being said, being aware of these things that have been embedded in our society, whether it has to do with racism, or white privilege, or undermining strong female, just recognizing these things can help us start to learn to move past it, and then also help raise our future generations on better media. I've been going back and forth in my brain about, you know, it's like, does art reflect life, or does life reflect art? And I think they both go hand in hand, but one thing that I feel that life reflects, it's film. The entertainment that we feed to ourselves, we rely a lot on that entertainment to teach us how to be in our lives and to set a good example. Film being such a powerful and riveting tool that can spark such strong emotional reactions and connections. That being said, surrounding ourselves with very diverse stories gives us a better understanding of all the different kinds of people that are in this world. Because there are so many different kinds of people. Like, it's not just us. It may feel like it's just us, and it may feel like the world revolves around everything that we do, but the fact of the matter is that there are so many people existing in so many places all simultaneously, and it's crazy because we will never fully understand someone else's experience, but the closest window into understanding those experiences is through storytelling. So, on a more personal level, I've just been really trying to become a better writer, because when I'm older and I'm directing movies, I want to be directing movies that I've written. And so in order to do that, I need to be a good writer. I've been trying to learn the difference between writing screenplays and writing poetry and books and more writing on that level. I don't know what it would be called. This is something I've struggled in with writing screenplays, is that when you're writing screenplays, you're literally writing something that is going to be shot by a camera, and it needs to be physical, and it needs to have some kind of action and some kind of thing that you can actually point a camera at and shoot. And you can't shoot inside someone's head and be like, I feel perplexed. You know, you can have wasted director, actors, and emotions to give them to feel, but at the end of the day, writing screenplays needs to be specific, and it needs to have some sort of physical manifestation. Which, the way that I've been writing them, is very, like, abstract. So that's something that I've been working on, is just reading a lot of screenplays. I've been finding them online and also ordering book versions, like little screenplays and books, so that's been really nice. So I've been reading a lot of screenplays, also reading a lot of books. One self-help book that I am reading is called Untethered Soul by Michael A. Singer. And I've only gotten 3 chapters into it, but I promise, this has been the most helpful book for me, like, that I've ever read in my life so far. Not sponsored at all, but this book has a little horsey on it. It helps make sense of the voice in our head, the voice that's always contradicting itself and arguing with itself and judging things around us and having opinions and causing anxiety and everything. That voice that we hear, but like we can physically hear it speak, it talks about how this voice is not us. Like, none of it is us. Not the bad things it says, not the good things it says. Like, this voice is not us. And to try and imagine it as if it's a roommate, as if it's someone sitting next to you who's speaking to you, it can allow you to just, like, exist without having to get so spun up in what it's saying because it's just an external thing. If you can hear something, that thing is not you. I used to just think about this all the time when I was really little. I would just think and I would think and I would be like, what if I didn't exist? What if nothing existed? Then there would be nothing. And I would just like think about it and think about it. Then all of a sudden I'd be like, oh my God, there'd be nothing. There'd be nothing. And it just like clicks in your head. And it's just like that one little second of like understanding and then it goes away. I think if we can understand it once, then we can continue to understand it. But there's some concepts that are so abstract, there can only be one instance of enlightenment, of understanding. Those are just some things. I'm gonna post a video soon. It's called Take Care. I posted on Instagram and asked people who follow me on Instagram if they wanted to be a part of a project on self-care. And then I have these people write on a piece of paper something or many things that they do for self-care. It was the most endearing thing, just hearing the little small things that people do to take care of themselves. I wanted to make a little video to inspire people just to take time for self-care, especially in crazy political and virus and social anxiety, like high school. Like, I don't know, I feel like most people watching me are like in high school, and high school is just, life is just, it's just overwhelming. And we need to take care of ourselves so we can walk through life as our best selves. That being said, I compiled all of these things that people sent to me into like a little short film. And then I shot it with my sister because we can only see each other because we're quarantined. And I think it's cute. And I'm posting it within the next few days, so stay tuned for that. July is soon. I love July. It's my favorite month because it's my birthday now. It's my birthday month. My birthday is on 7/11, which is crazy because those are my two lucky numbers. So I overall, just like July in the first place because 7 is my lucky number. I'm literally looking at so many sevens around my room as I speak just because I put 7 everywhere just because it's my lucky number. But also 11 is my lucky number and it used to be the number on my soccer jersey. And also, every year on my birthday, I get free Slurpees. Like, I feel good things coming in the future for everyone. Because I feel like, oh my God, there's 2 sevens on my lens. I just realized that it's a 77 millimeter. That's funny because I was just talking about 7. So, just things like that. This was my brain barf. I will see you very soon with probably another video of me rambling at you. I hope you enjoyed!